In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, amen.
Let us. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book from the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Set out for the great city of Nineveh, and announce to it the message that I will tell you." So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh, according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormously large city. It took 3 days to go through it. Jonah began his journey through the city, and had gone but a single day walking, announcing, 40 days more, and Nineveh shall be destroyed." When the people of Nineveh believed God, they proclaimed the fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil way, he repented of the evil that he had threatened to do to them. He did not carry it out. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the time is running out. From now on, those having wives should act as not having them. Those weeping as not weeping. Those rejoicing as not rejoicing. Those buying as not owning. Those using the world as not using it fully. For the world in its present form is passing away. The word of the Lord. This is a time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they abandoned their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat, along with the hired men, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Today, our scripture readings invite us to think about what it takes to say yes. From God calling Jonah a second time, to Mark's account of Jesus calling the first disciples. What does it take to get someone to say yes? In the Old Testament, reading from Jonah, we read the account of what happened after Jonah's time in the belly of a fish. God comes to Jonah a second time with the same request, namely, to go to Nineveh and proclaim God's message. The passage is sparse, not much there, not much in further details, only that by verse 4, Jonah is walking through Nineveh, proclaiming a message that in 40 days, the city will be overthrown or destroyed. Then by the next verse, the people of Nineveh believe Jonah, and they begin to repent. By the final verse of the reading, we see God's reaction of a changed mind, and no catastrophe befalls the city of Nineveh.
From that story of Jonah, we might conclude that all it takes is some time in the belly of a fish to get someone to say yes. But what turned the hearts of the people of Nineveh to get them to put on sackcloth? Clearly, God was at work through Jonah's message to change the people's minds and get them to say yes. The gospel story from Mark is very much sparse on details. Mark's gospel is known for being concise and very matter-of-fact. But the lack of details can be frustrating. After the arrest of John in verse 14, Jesus says the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. In verse 15, Jesus also says to repent and believe. Although the messages are different, both God, through Jonah, and Jesus want the same results. Both want people to atone and to believe. Mark's account takes another sparse twist in the next portion of the gospel. When Jesus calls the first disciples, Jesus calls Simon, Andrew, James, and John with the phrase, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of people." All the men left what they were doing and immediately followed Jesus. Their action was very much an active yes in Mark's telling of the story. Now, does these lack of details in both the Old Testament and the gospel lessons frustrate you in any way, or invite your imagination to fill in all the gaps? Maybe the people of Nineveh found Jonah to be a compelling preacher, even if it took Jonah 2 days and 2 tries to say yes to God. For the 4 fishermen, were the nets coming up empty that day? Was there something in Jesus' invitation to fish for people that was more appealing than casting their nets for fish? Maybe they said yes to just try something new and different. How do you say yes to someone? Through both stories, the Bible gives us clues on how Jonah and Jesus gave the invitation. We may wish for more details from Jesus than just an invitation, as with the first disciples. What was it about them that made them so willing to leave everything that they knew for a risky future? Maybe the key lies in what comes next after our passages for today have ended, and we read in the rest of Mark's gospel that the first disciples continue to say yes even when the going got tough. Will we be able to answer yes if God calls us? Will we continue to say yes like the disciples, no matter what the difficulty we meet?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, in Jesus Christ, His only Son, by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into heaven. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. There he will come to judge us today. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
walk together on a pilgrimage of faith, so we have the courage to pray. At this Mass, we remember in a special way Glenn Brown and Eugene Conway.
For the Church, that we may faithfully follow the Lord and draw others to Christ through our deeds of love and compassionate words, let us pray to the Lord. For our world, that the hearts will turn away from violence and toward pathways of peace in all nations and in the cities and towns in which we make our home, let us pray to the Lord. For greater authenticity in our lives, that in our ordinary activities and duties we may manifest the values and virtues of Christian discipleship, let us pray to the Lord. We pray in thanksgiving for the 50th anniversary of Henry and Anne Margaret Gronowski. May their witness of Christ's love and mercy be of inspiration for us to love others as Christ loved us. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are suffering from spiritual and physical ailments, that the Holy Spirit bring them healing and comfort. We pray for all the sick, especially for Kathy Coker, Amador Villanueva Jr., Laverne Lassos, Sylvia Arcos, James Baker, Maria Isabel Rizal, Salvatore Gigliardi, Richard Trapp, Rick Fleming, Paris Marino, and Federico Arrieta. Let us pray to the Lord. For the souls in purgatory and for those who have gone before us, that they find eternal rest at the hands of our loving God. We pray especially for Mary Fitzmaurice, Conrado Gagne, Barbara Cuccio, and Joseph Turl. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of everlasting life, you call us to abandon our nets and follow you. Give us the grace and strength to do your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Oh, no.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol with you all, with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all worlds. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink of it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. There with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other some sign.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
let us love one another.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the best, the family.